for many black queer boys or black queer kids, you often feel like you're the only one. And so, you know, reading George's words made me feel seen.
First of all, I just wanted to know, you know, what your first impression was reading All Boys Aren't Blue. I mean, I think it's just such a gorgeous, beautiful text in general. How did you guys feel? What was your first impression reading the text? Had you read it before you joined the project?
Well, for me, I already had the book, which was like, I believe in things happening, not by coincidence, but by divine interaction. And for me, it was like, okay, I already have the book. I'm already reading it. It's great. It's amazing. And then a friend of mine named Nasir was like, hey, I'm doing this project for this book. And I'm like, oh God, I'm reading it currently. And he's just like, would you be interested in being involved? And I was just like, is George involved? And I was like, okay, George is involved. Cool. Yes, I'm down. But even in my getting the chapter that I got, which was Nanny, it was parallel to my life already. Like, I grew up with my grandmother as well. So my relationship with my grandmother was very similar to George's relationship with his nanny. So I was extremely blessed. And I knew I wasn't gonna do the one about being an alpha, because I am a man of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated. So I said, Nathan, absolutely not.
You make that clear.
I was like, I will not be talking about Alpha Phi Alpha, no.
Oh man, no, that's great. I was actually wondering what went into choosing us for each thing. I was telling someone earlier that I did not pledge. I wish I had, but the journey, which is what I love about George's writing, like, I was like, I could relate so much to those college years and just trying to figure out who you are, and it feels like everyone's freaking watching and everyone's judging. Because this was my introduction to it, and I was reading the whole thing, and then I read my chapter several times, and I was like, oh, it's like someone reached into my soul and pulled out, which I think is the great thing about the book and the great thing about the special, is that you don't have to have had this exact experience, but you are going to feel yourself in all of these moments, you know, especially as a queer black guy. All of us have been told at some point, I know I still get it sometimes, that I'm just not black enough or manly enough or this enough or that enough. And just felt like George was siphoning things from my mind. It was really quite magical.
It's really great to sort of come into contact with material that really speaks to the experiences that I've had. And even though they, in the specifics of them, they may be different, but you know, going through the same sort of experiences with your identity and how you grow up. For many black queer boys or black queer kids, you often feel like you're the only one. And so, you know, reading George's words made me feel seen in a way that the little Dyllon maybe didn't know that it was possible to be seen when he was 6 and 7 years old, you know?